Okay, now everybody knows that I love the hounds, but Dee does as well, and lots of other people do. Dee, tell us a little bit about Afghan hounds and what they're like, and the kind of person who might want to consider them as a good choice for a pet.
Well, I think that somebody would like an elegant dog that is a larger breed, but yet doesn't necessarily have the weight factor. Somebody who will groom a dog, because they are long-coated and they do require grooming. But they're breathtaking to watch. They could be used in lure coursing and show, and just as a wonderful pet. They're very lounge-like and cat-like. They will lay beside you on a couch. And yet the nice thing about them, and a lot of people are not aware of, is that they're a single coated breed. They're non-shedding, so they fit very well into homes, and they're very good with family. Very, very good with family.
Tell me a little bit about what's involved with grooming. Is that something you do every day, and how much expertise is involved, and how much time?
I would recommend that you do run a brush through your dog every day, but an Afghan can have a bath. In show coat would have a bath once a week, but if it wasn't in show coat, could probably be bathed about every, you know, 3 or 4 weeks. A clean coat is a healthy coat. It is hair, not fur, so they do tend to, you want to brush it out and condition well. But they're very easy to maintain. They're not the nightmare that a lot of people think they would. If you don't brush them, they will mat. But, easy maintenance on a regular basis, and you're away to the races.
What do you think people would be surprised to learn about this breed?
They're smart. A lot of people say hounds are not smart, but if you ever lived with an Afghan, you would know. They counter surf. They're snitches for food. Because they're hounds, and yet they love to run.
Now, do you need a big piece of property to have a dog like this, or could even somebody who lives in the city be able to take care of an Afghan hound properly?
I have sold to both city homes and country homes. Afghans require regular exercise, but you can exercise them in a tennis court or a long walk or jog with them. So some people in condos have them. They are quiet dogs. I have people both living in condos and in homes. I do recommend a fenced yard, and they should be on leashes at all times, because if they have a prey drive, and if they do see a rabbit or something small and furry, they will try for it.
Mm-hmm. That's great. Thanks very much.
You're welcome.